Welcome to the library. This quick tutorial video will explain how to use the Cited By feature in Google Scholar. This feature allows you to start with one publication, a book or article, that you think is relevant for your research, and see who else has cited it. It's a great way to find other publications that might be related to your research. Citing publications allow you to jump forward in time to see newer but related resources, while cited references, the references cited within a publication, reflect research that is backward in time. To access Google Scholar, open a new browser tab or window and type scholar.google.com. Let's begin with an example. Suppose our topic is servant leadership. We can use the 2002 book by Robert K. Greenleaf, Servant Leadership, A Journey into the Nature of Legitimate Power and Greatness. Type or copy-paste the publication title into the search box. Typically, searching by the title of an article or book in Google Scholar is sufficient to locate the item you are seeking. However, if you cannot locate your resource by the title only, you can add more search terms, such as the author's name, using the Advanced Search option. You may access the Advanced Search option by clicking the three horizontal bars and selecting Advanced Search. In the Advanced Search box, add the journal title or the publication date to make your publication search more specific. Here, we quickly located the publication, and below the citation and key information, we can see the link that says Cited By. For this seminal book, we can see that it has been cited by more than 4,000 other publications since 2002. If you click the Cited By link, you can see the list of publications that cite this result. This is the first page of the citing publications for the Greenleaf book. There are several options available on the left side menu to sort and narrow the results. You can sort the citing articles by date, or limit the date to find the newest citing publications. You can also search within the citing publications. Click the checkbox underneath the search bar that says Search Within Citing Articles, and then enter your search terms in the top search box. For example, I will search for the phrase employee satisfaction. By searching for a specific keyword or phrase within citing publications, you are able to narrow the results to a more manageable set. Remember that not all search results in Google Scholar will have citing articles. The reason being that either the publication is too new to have citing articles, or the publication may not have gained enough influence or readership for other scholars to cite it. Many other databases in NCU Library offer options to view citing articles. To see the full list of databases, let's return to the library's homepage. From the library's homepage, go to Research Help and click on Research Process. From the Research Process page, scroll down to the section called Finding Similar Resources and click on the Citing Articles page. On the Citing Articles page, you can see a list of the databases in NCU Library that display citing publications when available. While many databases may offer the option to view citing articles, you may note that there is a discrepancy in the number of citations displayed among different databases and sources like Google Scholar. This is due to various reasons, including the range and type of resources indexed in the particular database. Google Scholar by far indexes more resources than most publisher databases, including Web of Knowledge, so it will display more citing article results. Here is an example of an article citation indexed in Science Direct database, which shows 130 citations. However, the same article indexed in Google Scholar shows over 400 citing publications. You will want to keep in mind that by searching for a citation in Google Scholar, you may be able to locate more citing publications that are relevant for your research. To learn more about other Google Scholar search strategies and tools, please see our Google Scholar quick tutorial video. We hope this quick tutorial video has been helpful. Remember to contact the library with any questions.